Okay, I gotta make sure we're live though.
Families, community members, and GHS staff. Welcome to the afternoon portion of Gimli High School's 2022 graduation ceremony. We begin our celebration today by acknowledging the traditional territory upon which we gather. Gimli High School is located on Treaty 1 territory and the Métis homeland. For any family members that could not be in attendance today, all ceremonies will be live streamed. The link will be available on GHS website and on EDSB. The processional will start momentarily. When all grads have entered and are before you, the music for the processional will end. Graduates will remain standing in front of you for the playing of O Canada, and then move to their assigned seats on the risers. We are extremely lucky to have a professional photographer here today to capture all the moments for today's ceremony. And these will all be shared with families at a later date. So feel free to sit back, relax, and take in all the moments. At this time, I would like to invite you to please rise for the processional and remain standing for the playing of O Canada.
Thank you.
And look at the camera on the
Please find your assigned seats.
Canada.
count the mistakes I make in an hour, so that was one. We are fortunate and excited to come together on this beautiful day to celebrate the graduating class of 2022. Graduating from high school is an important milestone, a celebration of your time with us and all you have achieved. Today offers a chance to be with the ones you love and connect with staff and the school one last time. If nothing else, today offers one last memory as we send you off into the world. Grads, as you think of your time at GHS, I hope you are excited about all you have accomplished. You should truly be proud of all you have done. Although you will likely forget at least some of the facts, the dates, the math problems you currently have buried in your head coming off exam week, be sure to remember the little things that happen along the way. From sports road trips to band concerts and everything in between, you all have created memories that should last a lifetime. Class of 2022, it is my challenge to you as you leave us to continue to learn each day. Stay active and engaged in your community. To show respect and kindness whenever possible. At its core, this is what it means to be a Laker. Be honored that you are a graduate of Gimli High School. You are part of one of the best communities. Before we proceed in the ceremony, I would like to share two housekeeping items. Because we are outside, our traditional baby picture slideshow will be shared online on our school website as well as Edsby. And the flowers you see before you will be given away as prizes at the conclusion of this ceremony. There will be one winner from this morning and one this afternoon, and if you're the lucky one, you'll be contacted tomorrow. At this time, I would now like to call on Miss Rosa Gray for the superintendent's address.
Good afternoon, everyone. Graduates, on behalf of everyone who's encouraged you, guided you, cried with you, and loved you along the way, congratulations. Looking around today, it's clear that graduations are a kaleidoscope of emotions. Pride, joy, relief, maybe, disbelief that the years pass so quickly, excitement for the potential that lies ahead, and because joy holds hands with grief, there's some of that too, because today is a milestone that your childhood is over. And this year, we're also grateful just to gather again, to celebrate together after the pandemic's disruption, to acknowledge the achievement of these graduates who were impacted by restrictions, remote learning, and missed opportunities. Well done, folks. For me, graduations also make clear how fiercely parents love their children, and how immensely, magnificently hopeful we are that our children will be happy and have purpose in life. But imagining our futures or the futures of our children can be really difficult, because after all, it wasn't so long ago that these graduates were young children following you and their siblings around, wanting to show you how much they loved you by talking to you all the time. But then, everything that they told you, you already knew. There wasn't much value add to your knowledge base from those conversations. But now that's changed. Now parents may wish for more talking, or they may wish to hear less about some things. I'm reminded of a conversation I had with my nephew, a recent grad. He was telling us about a course that he's in. Mid-sentence, he paused, saying, "Oh man, sorry, Auntie. I'm just thinking about how awkward it must be for you to not know what I'm talking about. How does it feel for you now that I know more about some things than you do, even though I'm so much younger than you, that I'm like surpassing you?" I know, right? I had no words. But this is what we hope for our children, that they surpass us, and maybe to be humble about it. We all hold hopes for these grads, but more important, graduates, is that you are hopeful for yourselves. So if my comments today are to have any value add for you, perhaps it's this. We used to think that hope was something, an emotion that we would have from time to time, dependent on our circumstances or our desires for the future. But what cognitive science shows us is that being hopeful is actually a way of thinking. It's an orientation that we can choose. Defined simply, hope is optimism with a plan. Hope isn't some gauzy rainbows and sparkles fantasy that you can do anything or be anything. That's a myth. Again, optimism with a plan. And optimism requires examples of who we might become and an imagination for an experience that's better than today. And a plan can be as simple and direct as a realistic strategy and one small step forward. And graduates, as you look at the grown folks here who have succeeded, it may seem as though the path was smooth and that they always had things figured out. I'm here to tell you that no one emerges ready-made. When it comes to family relationships, careers, emotional well-being, physical health, we are all a work in progress. Made for community, we all need support to find our way and to stay the course. Asking for help doesn't make us weak, it makes us real. And if there's something that we all need, it's real people to share life with. Researchers tell us that whether we're aware of it or not, we are influenced by those we're around, and we tend to mimic them. We become like the people we spend the most time with. Choose well. Putting all of this together, the most important advice I can give you is this. Understand who you are, know your story, decide to be hopeful. This will give you the power to guide your life. Finally, I end my comments to the grads the way I always do. As you move on and grow forward, remember to call and visit your parents and others who love you. They've got you. With our sincerest hopes that you will create and share hope, congratulations and all my best. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Gray, for your kind words. I would now like to call on Ms. Groot for her principal's address.
Our biggest and most important event of the year, celebrating the Gimli High School graduates, I am here to tell you to work hard, dream big, make mistakes, and be kind. So welcome to parents, family members, our wonderful scholarship donors, ESD Superintendent Mrs. Rosa Gray, School Board Trustees Gladys Kohler and Diana Auer, staff members of Gimli High School, and of course, the soon-to-be graduates of GHS, the class of 2022. It is so nice to see all of you in person and in celebration of these special graduates. As we reflect on our last 4 years of high school, we can't help but think of the many struggles that we have faced along the way. Being a new and little grade 9 in a big school, having your grade 10 year end with remote learning, and then starting your grade 11 year with COVID protocols, remote learning, adjustments to our teaching spaces, mask mandates, physical distancing, and sanitizing. There were a lot of challenges. Your grade 12 year also had its trials, with Omicron hitting us around winter break, just at the time when we were trying to move towards protocols that would bring back some normalcy to our lives. But you did it. You worked hard, learned both content knowledge and life lessons, and made it through. My first tip for you as you leave here and venture into a life of your own is to work hard. Whether you were like Gabby, Liam, and Brittany, who were very connected to their psychology class, or Nathan and Kyra, who couldn't get enough of chemistry. You all persevered and worked hard. You attended school, despite there sometimes being worry. You got in onto MS Teams, despite there being technical glitches. For those of you who enjoyed art class, like Luke, Ava, and Julie, you were resilient and kept graduation in sight. I appreciate your dedication, and know that you will continue to be hard workers in whatever life throws your way in the future. In reference to working hard, I will end this tip with a quote from Steve Jobs. He said, "Your work is going to fill a large part of your life, and the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. So don't settle. As with all matters of the heart, you'll know when you find it." Another tip for you as you move on with your life is to dream big. We need you. We need you to serve in our government. We need you to work in hospitals, courtrooms, and schools. We need your creativity and intellect to shape our future technologies. We need you to think about our environment and the ways to preserve it. This year, we saw so many of you dream big as you applied and got accepted into universities and colleges and made important decisions about what direction to take in life. We wish you well, Reeve and Alyssa, as you move on to work after high school. Attending college or university out of province will be quite an adventure. So for Braden and Elise, we know you are up for the challenge. And for those of you planning to further your education closer to home, Logan and Hannah, know that your big dreams matter and that you will be successful in anything that you attempt as long as you persevere. I want you to set lofty goals for yourself, as that is a great way to approach life. Whether it's Keenan wanting to play high-level football, or Mel, Taylor, and Emma wanting to see the world, these are wonderful aspirations. And even if you're not quite sure what your next steps will be, Kylie, Ethan, or Josh, it is important for you to have goals, and we know you will think big. Lofty goals can also force you to experience failure. My third tip for you is to embrace failure. It is essential to make mistakes. You made mistakes this past year, as did I. Whether it was something small, like getting to class on time, or me running late for a meeting, or progressively more of a worry, like not completing assignments, or me forgetting to hand something in to Rosa. We can always say, well, it could have been worse, and we might not be sitting on this stage today. Just remember that these mistakes, big or small, make us stronger and allow us the opportunity to make positive change. They push us to a better place every time and allow us to see that we are not in this alone. As you move on to bigger and better things, please accept your failures as an avenue for growth, because it is inevitable that we will fail. And my final tip for you is to be kind. Man, do we have amazingly kind and empathetic human beings at Gimli High School. Seeing Nayeli's beautiful smile over the last year as she moseyed along the hallways at GHS, experiencing Chloe as she interjected herself between two younger students, telling them to break it up as they argued with each other, and getting a chance to see Willow. Cross-country Willow, band concert day Willow, gradhead meeting Willow. She showed up everywhere. Well, everywhere that Zach Meadows was. It was fun and made for some good laughs, so thanks, Zach. These are true signs of emotional intelligence and something that we strive for in our community. My goal is that each of you be successful as you move forward in life. But please consider that being successful in life may be less about possessions and money and more about strength of character. Emily, Lee, and Zach Fedorchuk, each of you is so very kind, supporting others, never having an unkind word, and being happy with who you are. This is what we all strive for. Please continue to be you. Finally, my parting words today for each and every one of you that's graduating is that I wish you well on the big adventures that await you. Please work hard at your chosen job. Dream big about things that bring you joy. Make mistakes that you can learn from. And always be humble and kind. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Groot. The next part of our ceremony will be the presentation of graduate tributes, awards, scholarships, and diplomas. This will be done by Ms. Groot and Ms. Dan Kocek, our school principal and vice principal, Ms. Selkirk and Ms. Lavely, our school secretaries, and Ms. Noble and Ms. Bauer, teachers at GHS.
Firstly, on behalf of the graduates, their families, and our school community, I want to acknowledge and express our gratitude to the contributors of community scholarships and awards. You will see in your program that the awards are many. We are incredibly fortunate for the ongoing sponsorship from community members, families, and organizations. Even during uncertain times, you continue to support, invest, and instill hope for the future through the gift of post-secondary education. I want to acknowledge our honorary guests in attendance today. Seated in the East section over here, please join me in giving them a round of applause. Woo-hoo! We appreciate you.
I'm going to provide an explanation of the high school diploma categories. To achieve a Manitoba diploma, a student must have a minimum of 30 credits. To achieve the Manitoba diploma with honors, a student must have a minimum of 30 credits, a minimum average of 80% in all grade 12 courses. To achieve the Evergreen School Division diploma, a student must have a minimum of 32 credits. And to achieve the Evergreen School Division diploma with distinction, a student must have a minimum of 32 credits and a minimum average of 80% in 5 grade 12 courses that must include English and math. And lastly, graduates, here are your instructions. Here are your instructions. Each graduate will be called up to the stage only once for the presentation of diplomas, scholarships, and awards. When your name is called, please walk up to the stage and stand in front of the GHS archway. And as you approach the stage, we're going to read a personal note about you. If you're receiving scholarships and/or sports awards, these will also be summarized at this time. Students who are named to the All-Star Athletic Team are representative of athletes who show dedication to their team, are coachable, demonstrate sportsmanship, and through their efforts and abilities are difference makers on their teams. Once your scholarships and or awards have been announced, you will then face Mrs. Groot for the presentation of your scholarships and diplomas, which will be presented all as one package. Upon presentation of your diploma, you will face Mrs. Dan Kocek, who will flip your tassel from right to left to represent your status as a high school graduate. And finally, before returning to your seat, please pause for a picture. We have our professional photographer on site to capture the special moments. For those graduates who are receiving scholarships and awards, after the ceremony, Ms. Bauer will be directing you to return to the designated area in the back courtyard for a photo and a meet and greet with your scholarship donor. Any questions? No questions? All right.
Okay. And that means Melandria Bale, you are our exemplar. Come on up. Mel describes herself as funny and sarcastic. She will fondly remember grade wars, especially the grade 9 version. She plans to pursue studies in the field of education at the University of Winnipeg and hopes to one day travel to Japan. Mel is receiving the following scholarships. Kiwanis Matching Post-Secondary Scholarship for exhibiting good character, citizenship qualities, and being actively involved in volunteerism in the amount of $250.
University of Manitoba Special Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $2,000. University of Winnipeg Special Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $1,100. Mel has also been named as a member of the Athletic All-Star Team. Mel is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Mel.
Reeve can be described as quiet and intense. One of the times when he was definitely not quiet was when he was playing the tuba as a member of the GHS band community. Reeve is not sure what his future holds, but plans to seek summer employment and then see where life takes him. Reeve is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma. Congratulations, Reeve.
Braden Bomberak. Braden will be remembered as an outdoorsman, always hunting, fishing, or doing anything in the outdoors. He plans to go to Lethbridge Community College to study natural resources, with the goal of becoming a conservation officer so that he can protect the things that he loves most, the outdoors. Braden is receiving the following awards: the Evergreen School Division Award in recognition of his academic achievement, community service, citizenship, and healthy lifestyle choices in the amount of $500. Braden is also being presented an award of recognition as a member of the Provincial Championship Curling Team. Braden is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction. Woo! Woo! Congratulations, Braden.
Gabrielle Carter. Gabby, who can be described as resilient and compassionate, plans to complete her undergraduate degree at the Canadian Mennonite University in Winnipeg, then pursue a master's in psychology at the University of Manitoba. Gabby leaves us with this quote from Theodore Roosevelt: "Nothing worth having comes easy." Gabby is also receiving the following award: Constream Award for her community service and involvement in technology and or video studies in the amount of $500. Gabby is graduating with a Manitoba Diploma with honors. Congratulations, Gabby.
Logan Dykes. Woo! Logan bookended his time as a high school student with stints at GHS, returning to complete high school as a Laker. Never one to shy away from sharing his opinion, Logan leaves us to pursue a career in engineering, hoping to use technology to make life better for everyone, whether they like it or not. Logan is receiving the following scholarships and awards: the Peter Fraze Legacy Fund for demonstrating academic excellence in math and science. Preference is given to a graduate planning to study a math or science-related field at post-secondary, and this award is in the amount of $1,000. The RM of Gimli Award for attaining outstanding academic performance and being actively involved in school and community service work. This $500 award is presented to a graduate who resides within the municipality. The Schooley Johnson Scholarship for Excellence in English is awarded to a student who will attend the University of Manitoba and earn the highest academic achievement in English 40S. Schooley Johnson immigrated from Iceland in 1888, taught Latin and Icelandic throughout his career, and served as the head of Department of Classics at the University of Manitoba until his death in 1956. Logan is being awarded a scholarship in the amount of $1,050. and the University of Manitoba Special Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $3,000. Logan is graduating with an Evergreen School Division diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Logan. Zachary Fedorchuk. Zach, who can be described as both funny and kind, will cherish his memories from GHS, including going to basketball provincials in grade 9 and surviving grade 11 history class. Zach plans to become a teacher and hopes to one day go skydiving. Zach, aka Fedorio, lives by the quote, if you're not first, you're last. Zach is receiving the following scholarships and awards. Evergreen Band Booster Scholarship for long-standing participation in band, demonstrating commitment to his ensemble, being supportive of other student musicians, having gone above and beyond to help others succeed, contributing to community music events, and exemplifying the EBB mission and values. In the amount of $500. Royal Canadian Legion Gimli Branch Number 182 Scholarship, which is awarded to the child, grandchild, or great-grandchild of a veteran or eligible member in the amount of $500. University of Manitoba Special Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $2,000. Zach is graduating with an Evergreen School Division diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Zach. Liam Harapiuk. Liam is known as an ambitious and empathetic person. His proudest moment in high school was enrolling in our jazz band program. He'll be attending the University of Manitoba in the Faculty of Science with intentions to become a physicist. Liam is receiving the following scholarships and awards. Evergreen Band Booster Scholarship for long-standing participation in band, demonstrating commitment to his ensemble, being supportive of other student musicians, having gone above and beyond to help others succeed, contributing to community music events, and exemplifying the EBB mission and values in the amount of $500. The Evergreen School Division Award in recognition of his academic achievement, community service, citizenship, and healthy lifestyle choices in the amount of $500. The Laren and Heli Chris Jansen Family Bursary in recognition of his high potential for success, good academic standing, and community service. A humble and gentle man, Larry Chris Jansen believes in helping young people achieve their goals, so with his wife Helen, they established their bursary to ensure a deserving graduate would have the opportunity to follow their dreams. Liam is being awarded with the bursary in the amount of $6,585. We're not done. St. Michael's Catholic Women's League Scholarship awarded to a practicing member of St. Michael's Catholic Church for being an active in school, community, and or church activities in the amount of $500. And the University of Manitoba Special Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $2,000. Liam is graduating with an Evergreen School Division diploma with distinction.
Love you, buddy.
Congratulations, Liam.
This year, volleyball games, and the pig dissection in biology. Kyra plans to study sciences and eventually pursue a career in veterinary medicine. Kyra is receiving the following scholarships and awards. Albert Christensen Music Scholarship for her membership in the band program, involvement in private music instruction and peer tutoring, and demonstrating leadership by example in the amount of $300. Gimli Barvanok Ukrainian Dance Club, in recognition of her participation in the dance club, in the amount of $250. Life Touch Canada Award, in recognition of her significant contributions to the organization and planning of graduation day, in the amount of $250. MGEU Post-Secondary Area Bursary, awarded to the child of an eligible MGEU member for articulating how unions have improved her life, in the amount of $1,500. University of Manitoba Special Entrance Scholarship, in the amount of $2,000. West Shore Community Foundation Scholarship for her high potential for success, academic grades, and volunteerism, in the amount of $500. Kyra is also being recognized for her time and effort in varsity girls volleyball as this year's most dedicated player, and has been named as a member of the Athletic All-Star Team. Kyra is graduating with an Evergreen School Division diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Kyra.
Hannah Johnson. Hannah can be described as strong and compassionate. She plans to attend the University of Manitoba and pursue studies that will lead to a career in the medical field. Hannah hopes to one day take a Caribbean cruise. She leaves us with this quote by Rick Riordan: "If my life is going to mean anything, I have to live it myself." Hannah is receiving the following scholarships: QP Local Number 3164 Scholarship, awarded to a deserving student who is the child of a QP member, in the amount of $500. The Haley Duguay Memorial Scholarship, with preference given to a student intending to enter the healthcare field or early childhood education. Haley Dawn May Duguay was a free spirit who loved horses and spent time with family and friends. Her memorial scholarship is not based on academics, but rather humanity. Haley was the student who arrived to her 9 a.m. math class at 9:30 a.m. with a coffee in one hand and a purple binder in her other. Hannah is being awarded a scholarship in the amount of $1,000 in honor of Haley. Hannah is graduating with a Manitoba diploma. Congratulations, Hannah.
Keenan Karish. Woo! Woo! Keenan, one of this year's grad heads, will cherish memories of making cookies with Mrs. Schumach and playing on many sports teams. He will be pursuing a degree in animal systems at the University of Manitoba while playing football for the Bisons. Keenan plans to become a veterinarian and take over his family farm west of Seven. Keenan is receiving the following scholarships and awards: BMO Financial Group Indigenous Leader of Tomorrow Scholarship, for identifying as Indigenous, a minimum academic average of 90% in grade 11 courses, leadership quality and future potential, a high level of communication skills, community involvement, special abilities other than those shown by academic results, and proof of post-secondary acceptance to the University of Manitoba. Keen is being awarded with a scholarship in the amount of $16,000. Oh. Yeah, buddy. Woo. Derek Johnson Citizenship Scholarship, for achieving high academic standing, community service, demonstrating leadership, and the ability to communicate in public, which we all know you can do. This $200 award is given to a graduate from the Gimli constituency. Gimli District Health Auxiliary Bursary, for academic achievement of 75% or greater, good character, and intentions to pursue an education in the medical field, in the amount of $500. Harold A.C. Johnson Scholarship in Chemistry is awarded to a student who will attend the University of Manitoba and earn the highest academic achievement in Chemistry 40S. Harold A.C. Johnson held a Bachelor of Science with honors and a Master of Science in Geology and Computer Science from the University of Manitoba. He spent every summer he could at the family cottage in Gimli and had a lifelong interest in and commitment to the community. Keenan is being awarded a scholarship in the amount of $1,050. Life Touch Canada Award, in recognition of his significant contributions to the organization and planning of graduation day, in the amount of $250. Nuventus Credit Union Gimli Award, for good academic standing and involvement in community service, in the amount of $500. This recipient also pursues the highest standards of ethics and respect, has a positive attitude and outlook, and demonstrates accountability, cooperation, and leadership. Rotary Club of Gimli Award, for his academic achievement and involvement in school and community service activities, in the amount of $500. Arm of Armstrong Scholarship, given to a permanent resident in the Arm of Armstrong Municipal Area for scholastic achievement, school involvement, and community volunteer service, in the amount of $300. University of Manitoba Faculty of Agriculture and Food Sciences Centennial Entrance Scholarship is awarded to a University of Manitoba applicant planning to pursue a career in agriculture industry and who can articulate how they demonstrate an interest and a commitment to building a strong agricultural sector in the province in the amount of $2,000. University of Manitoba Special Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $3,000. Keenan is being recognized as the Varsity Boys Volleyball Co-MVP for his leadership and dedication to his team and the sport, and has also been named the Athletic All-Star Team. In recognition of his all-around athletic accomplishments and dedication to his team's success, Keenan has been named Grade 12 Male Athlete of the Year and will receive the Joey Roche Memorial Trophy. Keenan is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Keenan.
Lee Lapierre. Lee will be remembered for his basketball abilities and kind smile. He plans to go to college for fire and emergency services, and he wishes to travel the world and help people. A quote that Lee lives by is, "Yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery, and today is a gift." That's why it's called the present. Lee is being recognized as this year's Defensive Player of the Year for varsity boys basketball, as he could always be counted on to guard the opposing team's top player and took pride in being the thorn in their side. In addition, Lee has been named a member of the Athletic All-Star Team. Lee is graduating with a Manitoba diploma. Congratulations, Lee. Ava LaBelle. Ava is a kind, genuine, and determined individual. Her favorite memories of GHS were participating in and planning Spirit Weeks. Ava plans to attend Red River College to pursue architecture technology. She leaves us with the quote, "It's weird not to be weird." Ava is receiving the following scholarships and awards. Evergreen Basic Needs Community Achievement Award for dedication and service to others, devoting time and energy to making the community more caring, vibrant, and unique, and volunteering in Evergreen Basic Needs or contributing to the organization in a meaningful, thoughtful manner in the amount of $500. Gimli Art Club Marie Madeline Barge Memorial Award in honor of Madeline, a lifelong award-winning artist. In the Gimli Art Club, Madeline found good friends who shared her passion for painting and drawing. Despite serious health conditions, she carried on, and her family described her as a fighter with an incredible will to live. Ava is being $100 for her interest in art. Gimli Barvanok Ukrainian Dance Club, in recognition of her participation in the dance club, in the amount of $250. Kiwanis Matching Post-Secondary Scholarship for exhibiting good character, citizenship qualities, and being actively involved in volunteerism in the amount of $250. Ava is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Ava.
Zach Meadows. Zach, who is also a grad head this year, has fond memories of going to JV basketball provincials. Zach plans to attend University of Saskatoon while playing junior A hockey with the Ice Wolves or studying engineering at the University of Manitoba. He lives by the expression, it's always a good day to have a great day. Zach is receiving the following scholarships and awards: Evergreen School Division Award in recognition of his academic achievement, community service, citizenship, and healthy lifestyle choices in the amount of $500. The Rotary Club of Gimli Award for his academic achievement and involvement in school and community service activities in the amount of $500. The Schooley Johnson Scholarship for Excellence in Mathematics is awarded to a student who will attend the University of Manitoba and earn the highest academic achievement in Applied Math 40S or Pre-Calculus Math 40S. Schooley Johnson immigrated from Iceland in 1888, taught Latin and Icelandic throughout his career, and served as the head of the Department of Classics at the University of Manitoba until his death in 1956. Zach is being awarded a scholarship in the amount of $1,050. The Ted Jeremy Memorial Scholarship, awarded to a graduating student who was enrolled in a minimum of 4 courses with a minimum academic average of 80%, possesses leadership skills, and participates in extracurricular activities. The scholarship began in 1989 and to date has helped 33 students further their education. This will be the last year that Ted Scholarship will be offered, and Zach is being awarded $730 from the family. The University of Manitoba Chown Centennial Scholarship for being the best all-around student, having an academic average of 85% or greater, and will be attending the University of Manitoba in the amount of $1,000. University of Manitoba Special Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $3,000. The West Shore Community Foundation Scholarship for his high potential for success, academic grades, and volunteerism in the amount of $500. Zach is also being recognized for his dedication to track over his high school career as the most valuable track and field and cross-country athlete. Zach has also been named as a member of the Athletic All-Star Team. He is graduating with an Evergreen School Division diploma with distinction. Woo! Congratulations, Zach.
Elise Moore. Elise, a grad head this year, plans to study health sciences at Queen's University in Kingston, Ontario, including a year of study abroad in the United Kingdom or Australia. Her favorite memory is the Moose Jaw band trip, even though she was chased by a bee. Elise leaves us with the quote, "The most fantastic, magical thing can happen, and it all starts with a wish." Elise is receiving the following scholarships and awards: Gimli District Health Auxiliary Bursary for academic achievement of 75% or greater, good character, and intentions to pursue a career in the medical field in the amount of $500. Kiwanis Mel Osborne Fellowship Scholarship for contributing to the growth and work of Kiwanis through outstanding dedication and service in the amount of $500. Noventis Credit Union Gimli Award for good academic standing and involvement in community service in the amount of $500. Queen's University Chernoff Family Award for her superior academic ability, creative and original thinking, proven leadership qualities, and because she will be attending Queen's University from a rural or remote area of Canada in the amount of $48,000. RM graduate who resides within the municipality, University of Manitoba Special Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $3,000. And Elise has also been named as a member of the Athletic All-Star Team. Elise is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Elise.
Brittany Rogowski. Brittany, another member of the Grad Head team, can be described as hardworking and passionate. In the fall, she'll be attending the University of Winnipeg in the Faculty of Education. Brittany leaves us with this quote, "When nothing goes right, go left." Brittany is receiving the following scholarships and awards. Evergreen Teachers Association, awarded to a graduate intending to pursue post-secondary studies in the teaching or education profession in the amount of $500. The Lakeside Lions of Winnipeg Beach and Dunnottar Scholarship for demonstrating academic excellence and active community service in the amount of $500. Noventis Credit Union Winnipeg Beach Award for good academic standing and involvement in community service in the amount of $500. The University of Winnipeg Eleanor F.E. Black Entrance Scholarship, awarded to a student entering the University of Winnipeg upon the basis of their academic standing in the amount of $118. University of Winnipeg Special Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $1,175. Brittany is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Brittany.
Emily Shrupka. Emily, described as outgoing and confident, plans to study Earth Sciences at the University of British Columbia, Okanagan campus, while continuing with her modeling career. Emily hopes to be an activist for Indigenous rights and one day help get clean water and all First Nations communities. She leaves us with the quote, "Pain is temporary, but swag is forever." Emily is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Emily. Kylie Skirico. Kylie can be described as hardworking and passionate. Her favorite memories of GHS include winning a Grade Wars relay race in grade 9 against the grade 12s, being a grad head this year, and 4 years of Mr. Nickerson's English class. Kylie is unsure what her future holds, but sure hopes to decide someday soon. Kylie is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Kylie.
Emma Spring. And learning and growing as a person. One quote she wants to leave with us is from Nora Ephron, "Your education is a dress rehearsal for a life that is yours to lead." Emma is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma. Congratulations, Emma.
Taylor Sylvester. Taylor will be remembered as a student who enjoyed time with friends in between and during classes. She will fondly remember the silliness of senior prank day. Taylor hopes to one day travel and create her own adventures. Taylor is graduating with a Manitoba diploma. Congratulations, Taylor.
Luke Thompson. Luke will fondly remember his role as a member
concert and jazz band community. He plans to become a concept artist in the future. Luke leaves us with this quote from Henry Ford: "The only real mistake is the one from which we learn nothing." Luke is graduating with an Evergreen School Division diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Luke. Alyssa describes herself as quiet and caring. Her favorite memory of her time at GHS is Grade Wars, which she describes as unforgettable. She plans to take a year off, then pursue a career in law enforcement. Alyssa hopes to one day travel the world and especially hopes to visit Hawaii and Australia. Alyssa is graduating with a Manitoba diploma. Congratulations. Nayeli Taves. Nayeli can be described as creative and kind. Her favorite memory is a very special one, when she played the slapstick during Cumberland Cross at this year's spring band concert, and as anyone who attended clearly saw. Nayeli aspires to share her stories creatively, perhaps in a webcomic or graphic novel. Nayeli is graduating with an Evergreen School Division diploma. Joshua Turan. Josh is known as creative and funny. Although he is unsure how staff might remember him, we are sure to never forget his presence and contribution to the GHS fan community, especially the two straight years of hiding mini jars of glitter glue complete with code letters. Josh is graduating with an Evergreen School Division diploma. Congratulations, Josh. Ethan Tyndale. Ethan's friends would describe him as kind, funny, and unique. His favorite memories at GHS were spending time with his best and true friends. Ethan plans to work for a while, then travel to the Rocky Mountains to do some soul searching and enjoy the nature and the abyss. Ethan is graduating with a Manitoba diploma. Congratulations, Ethan. Nathan Vigvison. Can be described as outgoing, active, and fun to be around. His favorite memory during his time at GHS was going to basketball provincials in grade 9. Nathan hopes to one day play a round of golf at the Augusta National Golf Club. Nathan is receiving the following scholarships and awards: Canada Iceland Foundation, Margaret Bjarnason Memorial Scholarship for high academic excellence, involvement in extracurricular activities, and participation in community service work, in the amount of $6,000. Gimli Lutheran Centennial Scholarship, awarded to a deserving member of the Gimli Lutheran Church congregation with high academic achievement, in the amount of $500. The NASA Harbor Authority Bursary, for his involvement in community service, wilderness activities and experiences, strong connection to nature, and consideration of environmental conservation,
in the amount of $500. The Interlake Minor Hockey Dwayne Swanson Memorial Scholarship for being a determined, hardworking, and respectful teammate and student athlete who has positively impacted Interlake Minor Hockey in the amount of $500. The Robert Arneson Memorial Scholarship for his natural talent, commitment to community service, and strong work ethic. Robert was a teacher and a principal of Gimli High School and later elected as school board trustee for Evergreen School Division. He will be remembered as a kind, caring, and humble man with a great sense of humor, inspirational educator, dedicated community member, and exceptional role model. On behalf of the Arneson family, Nathan is being awarded with a scholarship in the amount of $1,000. The Rotary Club of Gimli Award for his academic achievement and involvement in school and community service activities in the amount of $500. The RM of Gimli Award for attaining outstanding academic performance and being actively involved in school and community service work. This $500 award is presented to a graduate who resides within the municipality. The University of Manitoba Special Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $2,000. Nathan has also been named as a member of the Athletic All-Star Team. Nathan is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Nathan. Julie, known as a quiet student, is always kind to others around her. She plans to pursue a career in welding after high school, but if that doesn't work out, she plans to become an artist. Julie is proud of her accomplishments and is excited to graduate today. Julie is graduating with a Manitoba Diploma with honors. Team. She plans to attend Brandon University to earn her Bachelor of Science degree and then pursue forensic science. Chloe hopes to one day travel to New York City to watch a Broadway musical and meet the Grinch at Universal Studios. Chloe is also receiving the following scholarships and awards. The Evan David John King Memorial Scholarship for being community-minded and well-rounded. Evan was a lover of all things sports, hardworking, compassionate, loyal, mischievous, and very funny. The King family is proud to donate this $1,500 scholarship in Evan's memory. The Gimli Art Club Award, in recognition of her unique and strong talent, conscientiousness, engagement in community outreach, and commitment to integrate creativity into her life throughout high school and into the future, in the amount of $250. The Christine Christofferson Memorial Scholarship, awarded to a sincere, cooperative graduate who is concerned about the well-being of others. Mrs. Christofferson was a dedicated professional who devoted over 30 years to teaching in the Gimli area. On behalf of the Christofferson family, Chloe is receiving a $200 award. The University of Manitoba Special Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $1,000. Chloe is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction. Congratulations, Chloe.
The final award this evening is the Governor General's Award. And it is one of the most prestigious a high school can, we have to go get it, can award. It is given annually How slow do I need to talk?
She wasn't kidding.
It is given annually to a student with the highest academic average in grade 11 and 12 subjects, as listed in the student's official transcript of grades by the Ministry of Education. It is calculated on final results after examinations. There is no differentiation between academic courses and vocational types of courses. On behalf of Her Excellency, the Right Honorable Mary Simon, presenting the award is Leona Groot, when she returns.
There she is.
Our principal of Gimli High School. This year's recipient of the Governor General's Award has an overall academic average of 99.04%. Please step forward to receive your Governor General's Award, Keenan Karish.
The real photo now.
Okay. Good. So proud of you, son.
This concludes the presentation of scholarships, awards, and diplomas.
For like 1 second here. You got it?
Yeah.
It's there. Okay. Welcome and thank you all for being here today to celebrate this monumental moment with us. We are so proud to be standing beside such a resilient group of people. People who we have called our classmates for the past 12 years. We still don't even know where the time has gone.
At the beginning of the school year, we are optimistic on what today would look like due to the public health orders and, of course, the cliche reminders to wear your masks, sanitize your hands, and the list goes on. It wasn't until after the new year that we could plan for a normal graduation ceremony, something that we will never take for granted.
Alongside a toilet paper. We have many memories to look back on in our elementary school years. The Gimli kids will never forget all the SSES Christmas concerts Mrs. Eastville put on. It was always something to look forward to, whether you had a solo, got to play Santa Claus, or were playing the xylophone. Everyone wanted to take part in the play. And before you got to perform your part in the concert, we got to watch a Christmas movie.
The Polar Express specifically. Keenan nor I went to Winnipeg Beach School, but here's a memory from students who did. They remember their final grade 8 field trip, going to play paintball in Winnipeg. Let's just say they really ended it off with a bang, and the school never booked paintballing again. Our grade wasn't always as close as we are now. In grade 8, our schools had the well-intentioned idea to bring the two grade 8 classes together to do a scavenger hunt. The only problem was, we stuck to our groups of Gimli kids versus Winnipeg Beachers. Now we couldn't be any closer, and we are so thankful to have each other, especially when it comes to chemistry, bio, or physics.
Thank God for group chats now. Coming into high school was such a shock for everyone. Grade 9 was a lot of learning and realizing that, in fact, the teacher will not answer half of the tests for you.
Cough, cough, Ms. Crimpinson.
We had to figure out for ourselves the routine for learning. Going into grade 10, we had a pretty good idea of that routine. Go to class, do some learning, maybe have a quick nap, and have a lot of fun along the way. That is, until COVID hit.
Living in a COVID world for the past 2 years has had a substantial impact on our high school experience. Being separated and segregated from our own classmates, as well as the other grades, took a toll on everyone. Who knew we would miss seeing the typical annoying immature grade 9s every day?
I sure hope we weren't that bad, guys.
It was hard to know if there was going to be a light at the end of the tunnel. Switching to remote learning was a challenge for everyone, teachers included. However, they say good things arise from bad situations. And we must admit, seeing everyone's morning expression was about the only good thing that came from remote learning. All jokes aside, as a class, we came out of COVID stronger and more interconnected than any previous graduating class. Although we missed out on a lot in grade 10 and 11, we can say we set a few new records in grade 12.
The first record being the most snow days in a single school year. We missed 3 weeks of school due to them this year.
Number two, we are the most unorganized grade ever.
We really, really suck at agreeing on things. And lastly, number three, we're the last graduating class to have Mrs. Borio as a sub for an entire school year.
We would like to thank our teachers for showing us how to grow into the people we are today, as well as the support and dedication to us. We would like to thank the graduating class of 2022 for showing resilience, thoughtfulness, and having a bunch of fun through our journey together. We would also like to thank all of you sitting in the audience. Moms, dads, grandparents, important people in our lives, as we wouldn't be here without your love and support.
Over the past 4 years, there's a lot to remember throughout our high school experience. For those of you who were a part of the grade 9 boys basketball team, we know you'll always remember how Fedorio got his nickname, or Mrs. Schumach's grade 12's foods class, where there was always some kind of dispute that may or may not have ended with a sass contest and a boot scootin' boogie-in. We know the people in shops class will remember the time spent working on projects together and fixing the things that they've broken.
Because apparently kids these days are hard on machinery.
And of course, the people in band class who will always remember Mr. Kroll's words of wisdom and the celebration of building the band room.
Whether you have plans to become a hockey player, a physicist, a teacher, or you have no idea what you're going to do, we know you will accomplish great things, and we can't wait to hear about them near the future. Today is a day for celebration, and we are looking forward to spending the night with each of you.
Fellow graduates, wherever life takes you, always remember the good times we've had together. Whether you're going to college, university, or are heading straight out into the workforce, be proud of who you are. Work hard, but also don't forget to have a good time, because as we now know, you don't know how much you'll miss something until it's gone.
Congratulations, class of 2022. Thank you, Kyra and Keenan. Before I invite our grads to stand up before us one more time, I would like to remind the grads and everyone else what this will look like. In a moment, grads will be invited to stand in front of the stage for a round of applause and the traditional cap toss. Grads, don't worry about finding your caps. We will get them for you and return them to you inside. Once caps have been tossed, enter the school once again at the... Sorry, let me try that again. Once caps have been tossed, enter the school once at a time from the center to the outside. Sorry, it's hot. Scholarship recipients return to the designated photo area from inside after the recessional for a photo with their scholarship donors. Family photo ops can occur on the stage by the main entrance to the school and anywhere you like outside. Grads, are you ready?
No.
No? At this point in time, I would like to invite you, the grads, to stand and one at a time return to your processional place at the front. Or all at once. Go to the spot with a piece of tape. leave everything, it's fine. Or carry it. It's your day. Graduates, class of 2022, this is the moment you've been waiting for. Get ready to throw those hats. Family, friends, loved ones, and staff, I proudly present to you Gimli High School's class of 2022.
Take that jump, don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. You fall in love and it hurts so bad.